On today's episode, a different approach to fusion power. Today's episode is brought to you by engineering.com, a globally trusted source for engineering content. Check out this and many other exclusive videos for the engineering professional found only on engineering.com TV today. Nuclear fusion technology is improving rapidly with this week's announcement from the Eurofusion Consortium that the joint European Torus in Oxfordshire, UK, generated a stable plasma for 5 seconds on December 21st. The energy of the plasma, 59 megajoules, is not large, about the amount needed to boil 60 kettles of water, but it surpasses the previous record from 1997 when 22 megajoules of heat were produced. The reaction burned a deuterium and tritium fuel mix, the same fuel currently used in the much larger ITER Tokomak in southern France, and the JET team expects that their progress in stable plasma containment will have applications in the much larger project. Both JET and ITER are toroids and use magnetic confinement to contain the superhot plasma. For decades, this was considered the only practical way to handle plasma, which is so hot that no known material can contain it. There are other alternate techniques, one of which is under construction now by Vancouver, Canada-based General Fusion. The firm uses a unique technique, mechanical compression of a large spherical mass of liquid metal to symmetrically collapse a liquid vortex cavity in a few milliseconds. The fusion reactions create heat which is absorbed by the liquid metal and can be extracted to power turbines. A test reactor is under construction at a UK Atomic Energy Authority site in Britain. Another novel approach is under development by Foothill Ranch, California-based TAE Technologies, who developed a linear device using technology that the firm calls an advanced beam-driven field-reversed configuration. This approach is radically different from Tokamak's or compression technologies, combining conventional plasma containment with a particle accelerator in a hybrid arrangement that can accommodate hydrogen boron, deuterium tritium, or deuterium helium-3 fuels. The firm has been experimenting since 1998, and the current fifth-generation reactor prototype is compact by large torus standards, at 80 feet long, 22 feet high, and weighing approximately 60,000 pounds. The reactor cost $150 million to build and currently operates on hydrogen and deuterium fuel. The accelerator component of the reactor injects neutral beams to heat and stabilize fusion plasmas, and the firm believes that the technology can be adapted to create a treatment system for selectively targeting cancer cells. Power production is, of course, the primary goal, and the current system operates at around 70 million degrees Celsius. Temperatures needed for the preferred aneutronic hydrogen-boron fuel are several billion degrees, and the temperature rise by a factor of almost 30 will be a technical challenge requiring a new generation of test reactors. The problem is immense. The plasma is described by hundreds to thousands of variables, and to infer plasma behavior from multiple indirect measurements, the company uses a Google AI system to simulate instrument readings from specified initial plasma conditions. TAE believes that this combination of a heavily instrumented device and the modeling power of Google's supercomputer will lead to a rapid understanding of plasma density and temperature, which are essential for break-even fusion power production. And what does the firm regard as rapid? The current estimate is that a workable prototype for the commercial reactor could be ready in a decade. Well, that's it for today's episode of This Week in Engineering, brought to you by engineering.com. For our deeper engineering series, visit engineering.com TV for exclusive shows like Manufacturing the Future and Designing the Future, not found on our YouTube channel. The links are in the description below. Thanks for watching.